Hello and welcome back to the channel. This video is all about how you can complete a Microsoft AZ-900, which is Azure Fundamentals certification, in just 2 days. So without further ado, let's get into it. So if you are completely new to the cloud computing world, or you are changing your career, or you just need to brush up your basics, this certification is a great start for you if you are looking to get a fundamental knowledge of all the Azure services as well as the core concept of cloud computing. So let's take a deep dive of what is needed to complete this certification, and also we'll discuss it, is it worth it or not. So first thing I want to clear is that this certification is not a prerequisite of any other associate level or an expert level certification. So if you have like the expertise in the field of data engineering or the database administrative or the cloud developer, then this certification may not be required for you. You can just continue with the associate level certification like the DP203 for data engineers, AZ104 for Azure administrators, and DP205 for database administrator. But if you're looking to get you started with Azure, then you come to the right place. So you may ask where we can prepare for the certification. So there are different courses are available on YouTube as well as Udemy, but I'll strongly recommend you to go through Microsoft's Learn website and follow the path, and that will be enough for you to crack this certification, because I also gone through it. It is very straightforward and the content is so good that you will not need anything more to crack this certification. And it is not just cracking certification, you will able to learn all the basic stuff which is required to you to get started with Microsoft Azure. But if you have some doubts or you just need to learn more, then you can also explore other courses, and I also gonna give you some of my recommendation of Udemy courses in the description below. So if you have any issues, you can let me know in the comments and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. So if you just want to complete this certification in a weekend, then you need to split all the syllabus in 3 parts. The first one is cloud computing basics and core concepts. Then the second one is Azure architecture as well as the different services provided by them. And the third one is Azure administrator and governance. So let's discuss these topics one by one. So in the first topic, which is related to cloud computing concepts, you will get to know what is cloud computing and their different types, like the private cloud, hybrid cloud, as well as the public cloud, and what are their pros and cons and what will be the best solution for your requirement. So that is a very fundamental knowledge that everyone should have, because the next step are totally dependent on what type of service you will be needing. Then also you should be learning about the different services, like the infrastructure as a service, where we have all the control on your processes and the data. Then we have the platform as a service, where most of the administrative tasks are handled by the cloud provider. So in this case, it will be Microsoft Azure. And the third one is the platform as a service, where all the administrative tasks as well as the scalability and all these background activities are totally handled by Microsoft Azure, and you will be the one who consumes the service. You don't have to make any configuration at the front. So the best example would be the Gmail. You just use the Gmail, but you don't need to worry about the storages and the backups and all the things that will come in the background. So you will be also comparing the on-premise services as well as the cloud services, and which one will be the best solution for you. So whether it is a total cost of ownership, as well as the scalability, reliability, fault tolerance, and all these aspects will be checked, and you'll get to know the real power of cloud computing and what are the different benefits as compared to the on-premise services. So all this knowledge will be enough for you to build your basics of cloud computing. So if you're liking this video, please consider subscribing, because why not? It's totally free of cost and it will really motivate me to make such videos for you. So the second part of this syllabus is Azure architecture and the services. So this is where you start your journey in Microsoft Azure. So first of all, you will be setting up your Microsoft Azure account and subscribe for a free tier account. Because let's be honest, you don't need that much computation power to get you started. If you're just for learning purpose, then free tier subscription will be more than enough for you. So at the end of this section, you will be able to create your Microsoft account, sign up for a free tier subscription, and also deploy your Azure resource. So in this part, you will also able to learn what is Azure Virtual Machine. You will able to create one virtual machine for yourself. And if you don't have the Azure subscription or don't have any access for that, then don't worry. The fundamental knowledge will be enough for you to crack this certification. You will also be able to learn the different Azure storage options and also create for yourself. So you'll be able to learn how to deal with different data structures like structured data, semi-structured data, as well as non-structured data, and what are the different storage options are available for all this stuff. So here comes the last section of this certification, which is related to Azure management and governance. So in this section, you'll be able to learn all about the different Azure services which are provided for calculating the total cost of ownership, as well as the governance and monitor your resources in Azure. So in this section, you'll be able to learn what factors will affect the cost in Microsoft Azure. So here, they will provide you different services like the total cost of ownership calculator, which is also known as TCO calculator, which will able to give you comparison between the on-premise services versus the Azure services, and what difference does it make for your requirement, and what will be the best choice for you. This section will also able to learn all about different services which are required to stay compliant, and for governance, which are nothing but Azure blueprints and Azure policies. This is very vital if you're building a well-architected framework in cloud. And as I mentioned before, you will also able to learn about how to monitor your resources in Azure. So there are different services which Azure provides to monitor your resources: Azure Service Health, Azure Advisor, as well as the Azure Monitor, to monitor all your resources which are deployed in cloud. So this was all about what you will learn in this course. And it is totally free of cost, so I'll highly recommend you to visit the website. So I'll also link it in the description below, which has these three sections and different modules for each services. So now you may ask how we can complete all this syllabus in just 2 days, because it's quite difficult, right? No, you're wrong. It is not that difficult. I know it's intimidating to talk about all these different services, because some of you may haven't heard all about it, and this will be the first time you are learning cloud computing. But this is not intimidating at all. If you go through the concepts one by one, then you will able to absorb all of it in very small time. And this is not like you have to do it in 2 days. If you need some time, that's totally okay. Because if you are totally new to cloud computing, then yeah, this might be a little bit challenging for you in the first initial days, but you'll definitely able to pick it up in some time. So we have the three main topics. So the first one is very important, where you will learn all about cloud concepts. So I highly recommend you to give it at least one full day and absorb all of it. But if you know all about the basics, then you can jump on the next topic on the first day itself. But if you are new to cloud computing, then you should give a complete first day for that topic. Then comes to the Azure architecture and services, which is the second topic. And the last one is the governance and compliance. That will be the last topic. So if you know all about the cloud computing basics and you just here to brush up your basics, then I'll recommend you to complete the first two sections in first day. And you can give a half of day for the third section, which is governance and compliance. And the rest of the day, you can definitely attempt some mock test or see some sample questions. So I'll also giving you same in the description below as usual. So this will be enough for you to appear for the exam. So the last question you may ask is it worth it? So the short answer is yes. AZ900 certification is a fundamental certification, and it is not that much difficult, but yes, it is worth it, because it proves that you have the fundamental knowledge of cloud computing, as well as the core concept of Azure and its architecture. And it's also a good addition to your resume as well. So if you are a fresher and if you have like a 1 or 2 years of experience, then this certification will totally add the value in your career. So in the US, it starts with $100, and in India, it's around 4,000 rupees. So it's totally worth it, but don't think that This certification will alone give you a job in the cloud computing world. You have to at least have an associate level certification or an expert level certification to land your dream job in cloud computing. But to get you started and prove your fundamental knowledge in cloud, this certification is a good addition in your backpack. So I hope I'm able to solve all your queries. So if you have any question, you can definitely ask me in the comments and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. And best of luck for you to complete this certification. Because if you just complete this level step by step and go to it thoroughly, then definitely you will able to crack this certification without any hassle. And some of you may also able to get it completed in a weekend as well.